Hi everyone, it's Vicky here with another idea on how you can use the October Card Kit by Simon Says Stamp. To start, I am going to use the black cardstock that was included in the kit, and I am going to create a standard card that's 4.25 by 5.5. I'm going to put this aside and I am going to cut out a panel out of this pattern paper using my stitch die by Simon Says Stamp. For the focal point of my card, I am going to use a journaling card that was in the kit, and I am going to cut out the typewriter. I will not pay any attention as I'm cutting it out to the paper that comes out of the typewriter, since I am going to replace it with another paper and actually turn this to a three-dimensional element. You'll see what I mean. Now I am using my craft knife and I am going to cut out this paper, and I am going to remove it completely from the typewriter. And as I am doing that, just to remind you that there is a giveaway running on my blog the whole week, and you still have time to enter your name until Saturday night for a chance to win this card kit by Simon Says Stamp. You will find a link to my blog to enter your name just below in the details area if you are watching on YouTube. And as always, you will find a linked list of all the supplies that I'm using today just below in the details area of YouTube or on my blog. Now I have my typewriter ready, so all I need to do is to cut out a piece of paper that can fit inside that typewriter. I will use my pencil to mark exactly where I want to cut this paper, and you can see how nicely it slides. I'm going to demonstrate this for you, but I will work on this paper later on. I am going to create a frame out of this pattern paper, which is nice and colorful, and I have used two rectangle stitched dies out of the set that I have by Simon Says Stamp. Now all I'm going to do is to add some foam tape at the back, and I'm not going to create a Sacred Window again, but I want to have a frame that is slightly raised than the rest of the area. Just because I am going to add dimension on my typewriter, I wanted to have a raised frame too. This is going to create a nice finished look for my card. And the pattern paper that I've used for the frame actually has some nice gold foil details on it. Now that my card base is ready, I am going to work on the paper for the typewriter. I am using the word hello, which is from the stamp set that was included in the kit, and I am stamping it a lot of times with black ink. I am also going to stamp it once about the center of the paper with the gold ink pad. This is the one that was included in the kit as well. So now that that's there, I am going to continue stamping with the black to fill in all the piece of paper that comes out of the typewriter. Now that my paper is ready, I am going to slide it through my typewriter, and I am going to secure it at the back with some tape runner. Just because I want this paper to be curved, I am going to do some curves with my fingers, and I am going to make sure that I secure this at the back with foam tape. This is going to add dimension on my typewriter, and it is also going to make sure that this paper is going to stay curved just like I want it to be. You can easily recreate this card, and just by changing the sentiment, you can make any type of card. So instead of a hello card, it can be a thank you card, a miss you card, a happy birthday card, or whatever you can think of. In order to keep that wave on the paper, I am going to add just a line of glue with my glue pen there. And now that I am going to stick it down, you will see how this is going to be dimensional. I just love having dimensional elements on my cards. I think that it brings them more to life. So I am going to show it to you on the side so that you can see how dimensional it is. to finish off my card, I just had to bring my Clear Wing of Stella glitter pen and add some shimmering details on my typewriter. So that was the card for today. I hope you had fun and got inspired. And if you did, don't forget to leave me a comment as well as give me thumbs up on my YouTube channel. Don't forget to visit my blog and enter the giveaway. Here are some close-up photos of the card. If you need more inspiration, here are a couple of cards great for fall. Just click on any of those two videos. But if you are watching from a mobile device, then you can find links to both those videos just below in the description area, or you can click the info card that just popped on your screen. Thank you all for watching.